We've had a good start to the season, but we always had this in the back of our minds, I suppose, at the end of the three-game block that we were coming up against a team who's just been so impressive for such a long period of time, and obviously in their own backyard. So they're an incredibly proud club with great players and a phenomenal coaching team. So we knew we'd have to be certainly emotionally ready for it, as well as obviously trying to be technically and tactically competent as much as we could. I thought it was a great first half. We obviously got into, I think it was a 13-point lead at the half, and we felt like we were in good control of the fixture. We always felt they'd come in the second half and probably up the tempo a little bit. Never lost our composure or physical will or intensity in the game, and that saw us through at the end. Obviously, his goal line stands there, and we, you know, to finish it out like that's just obviously superb from our perspective. It's an unbelievably close-knit group. They're extremely proud of their area and proud of representing their club. In a lot of cases, they've been there since they were five or six. They have family members who've played, and they're just an extremely proud group. And it's going to take something special from somebody else to match them on intensity or match them on drive and will for the game. Now we want to try and be as creative as possible and play as good rugby as possible, because that's part of representing the club to the best of our ability. So we take that really seriously, as well as we do emotional energy. But emotional energy won't win you every game. We've got to get a little bit better, I think, in terms of particularly our attack side of the ball, and just make sure that we continue to drive all areas.